Hey guys, Hillary here from Old World Home. Welcome back to my channel. One of my absolute favorite resources when it comes to home decor and decorating ideas is absolutely Pinterest. I know Pinterest has been around for such a long time, but I absolutely still use it and love it. I love to go back into my Pinterest boards and really see those themes that stand out to me and those decorating elements. I always suggest Pinterest to people who are curious to really discover what their decorating style is. I always say, go to Pinterest. Now Instagram has Instagram tags, so I do that too. But Pinterest is such a huge catalog of images and design inspiration. So most of you know that I love an old world feel. I love sort of an English cottage country feeling in my home. So today I want to share with you three different small kitchen updates that we tackled recently that were all Pinterest inspired. So the first update is something that has been in my mind for honestly the past 3 years since we moved in. We finally updated these sconces on either side of our kitchen window and above our sink area. When we bought the house, it came with these sort of outdoor light fixtures that had these interesting spindle tops. And we actually took the tops off, we flipped them upside down and painted them white to sort of just make them disappear, honestly, and make them blend in. It was never really my style, it wasn't something that I was excited about. So I continued to do some research and I finally came across a pair of sconces that I absolutely love. And they were from Amazon, of all places. The Pinterest images that I have loved and tagged and saved for all these years, every time I would go and source out a light fixture that I loved, they were always really expensive. And I do think that, you know, in our own homes, we sort of choose where we want to splurge and where we want to save. So if I could get the look that I wanted for much less, I was very excited about that. I love the scale of them, which are perfect for above our sink. We didn't have a ton of height to work with, and I love the linen shades that came with them. That was definitely the selling point for me. I love using light fixtures in kind of unexpected ways. So someone might look at that fixture and think maybe it belongs more in a bedroom or a living room or something like that. I love it in our kitchen. I think it makes it feel a little more cozy, a little more homey, because it has that, you know, texture and that material to it. That may just be me, but I love it. And just to further protect them, I did spray them with Scotchgard. That will help to, you know, deter any spills that might splash up from the sink or any dust that gathers on them. Of course, I can always take them off and wash them if any really crazy mishap happens, but I really am just so happy with them. My second Pinterest-inspired update was to add corbels to the base of our glass-fronted cabinet. My all-time favorite kitchen that I have ever pinned has these same corbels underneath all of the cabinetry, and it's just something that I have been in love with for so many years. I love the look of it. I love that it looks built in. It adds a lot of architectural interest. And we decided to put it just underneath the glass fronted cabinet. We wanted to sort of just make that one piece feel more built in. And then the rest of the cabinets, we decided to leave them off, mostly because of arrangement and just the way that our cabinets are laid out. It didn't really make sense to put corbels under each of them. And yes, we are all quarantined right now, but the great thing is that we can still order from Amazon and Home Depot and do these small projects to, you know, keep our sanity and to make our homes beautiful. So Dan helped me to install them and then I painted them white and we just love how it looks. This cabinet itself does house the electrical components for the sconce. And then there's also some accent lighting inside of this cabinet, which the previous owners had installed. They had stained glass in those glass panels, and I guess they wanted to highlight it. So inside this cabinet, there is some extra electrical sockets and things that we would love to take out, but it's just not something we feel the need to tackle right now. So we just left it all inside, which leads me to my third project, my Pinterest-inspired project, was to paint the inside of this cabinet white. Originally, it was just the wood, the original wood. It was a really pretty quick project. I just vacuumed out, you know, everything that was inside, any little crumbs or dust. I wiped it all down, and then I painted it with my trim paint that I already had on hand. It's a semi-gloss, so I thought that it would give the best protection as dishes and things were pulled in and out. So I did need to do two coats. The first coat kind of acts more like the primer. In this case, the paint does have primer built in, but I did need a second coat to finish out the cabinet. And I just love the overall feeling in the whole room that this cabinet doesn't look so dark off to the side. It's much brighter. It's kind of a gloomy day today when I'm filming, but it really did make a big impact, and it was completely free just with paint I already had on hand. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing our three small updates to our kitchen. We love how far this kitchen has come in the past 3 years, just doing small projects here and there. It just makes us so happy to work in here, and we are in this kitchen so much more these days due to the quarantine and isolation, but we are making the most of it, and I hope you guys are too. If you are new here, I'd love to have you stick around and subscribe. I do love to share all about our home, and I am doing Veda this month, which is a video every day in April. So hopefully you will stick around, and I'll be talking to you soon. Take care, guys.